We're going to do a quick overview of what the campaign manager is and all the different tasks that you can accomplish inside of it. So essentially, the campaign manager is your headquarters where all of your campaigns are sending out. And this is the best way that you can decide how and when you're going to communicate externally to your customers and all the benefits of providing product and customer support. So on the positive side, it's a way to thank your customers, get them to leave feedback and product reviews, as well as maybe send them PDFs or value adds. And also, by being able to communicate in a strategic way, you can avoid negative feedback and product review issues. So when you're looking at the screen here, here are the campaigns that are currently running. You can see that they're active, and each campaign is tied directly to a template that you edit in the template manager. Okay, so here's the email that's going to be tied to that campaign. And each campaign, you can decide which orders it's going to be tied to, whether it's FBA, FBM, and then you can set the timing and the rules for when exactly the emails go out, whether it's based on time or a metric is triggered, such as an order is returned or shipping has been updated. So let's go jump into a campaign here. When you go into campaign, you'll see the campaign name, which template it's tying into. You can apply a color label for your own internal reference, whether or not it's active or inactive, and which marketplace it's applied to. And then this is the status, the target metric that's going to be triggering this campaign. And so right now we're on positive feedback, and you can choose shipped, delivered, return, negative feedback, promotion, shipping promotion. These are the kinds of orders that are going to be tied to, so FBA and FBM. Any exclusions when not to send these campaigns out, for instance, if you know you received a return or if there was negative feedback, you did not want to email this person. And this is the schedule, so you can decide if it's going to be on a specific date after the target order has been triggered or if it's going to be as soon as possible, so anywhere between 15 to 25 minutes after it's been triggered. And then you can decide what products this campaign is going to be tied to, whether it's going to be all products or assigned to specific ASINs or SKUs. This is the template that you can edit. Here are some statistics where you can see how many emails have been sent, as well as the open rate. And then here you're able to edit, duplicate, delete, preview, look at the stats, as well as set up your A/B split testing. So generally speaking, you know, a suggested email campaign may be sending out the first email after order is shipped with product instructions, sending out a second email after the order has been delivered, so say 3 or 4 days after delivery, just to make sure that everything's okay and to see if they have any questions. And then a third email, maybe 7 to 10 days later, as a final follow-up and as a subtle way of saying, hey, if you could leave a review and feedback, it would really help us, and it helps like-minded customers find products like ours. So that's all the stuff you can accomplish within the campaign manager.